Hey everybody, it's Carpo here, and I just wanted to share a quick message that just ran through my mind while I was working out there. I was out in doing my office, doing some work for various things, and I had this idea of how I like to make people happy. It's always a thing of mine. This is why I always give extra samples, let's say, with my orders, or try to give a friend something that they may not have, or, you know, give them whatever I can do in my own way. And it got me thinking about how everyone has their own way of helping out the world and helping out other people. It may be small, or it may be large, but don't ever let anyone tell you how you should perform charity. I think that it's a very prevalent thing within our society that anyone who has a cause or something they stand up for and believe in, they're always wanting other people to stand up for that too. And that's understandable. But what they're really trying to do is find people with like-minded passions so they can share in the experience of talking about this particular issue. For example, some people help through service in a soup kitchen. Some people actually have extra money that they can send to charities or donate. And some people merely make small contributions through their entire lives, through their businesses or their daily dealings. And what's really important is the ethics. It's not about what you give or how much you give. It's about having the ethics to understand that you have to share when you can, if you expect to be shared with. It's a very simple, basic rule of life that we know, that unless you give, you won't have much to take. But ultimately, it's not about taking. I bring that up because a lot of people get trapped in the karma wheel in their minds, that they find themselves doing good things and wondering, am I doing this for the right reasons? See, there are people that give and do great things to help others and never question why they do it. It makes them feel good. Then, sometimes a philosopher may say, hey, am I doing this for my own ego, to make myself feel better because I help other people? Or am I doing it to be liked because I don't feel like I'm well enough liked? Or do I do it out of guilt because I have too much and I feel like I should contribute? In other words, say a rich person donating money but not really wanting to do it, but feeling obligated? There are all these little questions that arise through an individual's questioning of why they do certain things. But set all that aside. It becomes irrelevant. You pick what you want to focus on, you pick what's important to you and whatever moves you, and that's what you do. That's how you help. It may be something very small. You may think that you're not helping anybody out in your life, but you may be a very well-spoken individual that has really helped out a close friend or family member merely by being patient with them. And that, my friends, is a gift in itself. Material gifts and material charity are not the only things that matter. We know this. Working in a soup kitchen is no material goods, but you're giving a service. And ultimately, we do discover in life that service is what makes us happy, service to others. If we serve ourselves, we become self-serving. And in that case, we can feel like we're doing well. We can keep ourselves wrapped up in our tight little bubble, not be affected by any other cultures, any other political views, just live in a small-minded area where we're not affected as much by that. But today, that's changing. It's very difficult to turn on the television or get on the internet or even talk to people at the workplace without issues of major problems with corruption and greed and hatred coming up at the workplace or on the internet. You can't hide from these things anymore. And so people start to feel a little bit of guilt and they want to help out. So my message here is to say, you may be helping out more than you realize. If you're a good-mannered person and you have good values and good judgment, you're probably doing something to help in some way. So give yourself a little bit of credit and don't beat yourself up. You know, we're all trying the best we can, and at the same time as helping, we also have to survive. And that's one of the difficult aspects when you're living hand to mouth, check to check, and you've never had enough money to buy anything extra. If you're the kind of person like me who shops based on the price of the item and not the item you want, then you understand what I'm talking about. That it's easy to say, I shouldn't have to donate or help anyone because I can barely feed myself. But just remember, no matter how unfortunate you are, there are always people that are less unfortunate, or less fortunate, sorry, or people who may just need a little boost at that time of need. maybe a friend who went down the wrong path, started taking narcotics, maybe got into cocaine, or maybe they just became greedy, maybe money became their life, or they just became hateful or abusive. And instead of casting them away, we rediscover and rekindle that connection with them and help them through that. It was something that occurred to me this morning because I thought of a friend of mine who went down the wrong path in the last couple years, and I kind of dismissed him. I never considered him one of my greatest friends. He was more, but he was a friend. We grew up together, and I knew him well. And it's not a matter of how much of a friend I am, it's a matter of me feeling like I want to help him, because I feel like I can talk to people in a way that I'm not condescending or hurtful. So, give back in any way you can, and help somebody if you can. That's my message. Have a great day, and everybody, and I'll